Welcome to this spoken tutorial on email configuration for DSpace on Windows OS. In this tutorial, we will learn to configure an email for DSpace, prepare a batch file to rebuild DSpace, and send a test mail from DSpace. This tutorial is recorded using Windows 10 64-bit OS, DSpace version 6.3, WordPad, and Firefox web browser. However, you may use any other text editor or browser of your choice. To practice this tutorial, you should have installed DSpace 6.3 and you should have a working internet connection. If not, then go through the prerequisite installation tutorials on this website. The commands used in this tutorial are in a file in the code files link on this tutorial page. Please download and extract the file before practicing. I have opened the commands file in WordPad on my machine, and I will use the same file to copy-paste the commands during the demonstration. The shortcut to paste on the command prompt is Ctrl and V keys. In DSpace, we have to configure the email settings to send emails from DSpace. DSpace sends emails to the users for various activities such as email verification during registration, notification emails during item submission and review, getting DSpace users' feedback, and notifications to community and collection subscribers. Let us begin. In the file browser, go to C drive. Browse and navigate to the config folder in DSpace-6.3-src-release as shown. Open the configuration file DSpace.clg in WordPad editor. DSpace.cfg file is now open in WordPad. Scroll down and locate the email settings section. DSpace requires SMTP service to send and receive emails. SMTP services like Gmail, SendInBlue, SendGrid, PeppyPost, Amazon SES, or Mandrill can be used. Additionally, custom SMTP services can also be set up and used as well. In this demonstration, I will configure a Gmail SMTP mail server. So first I'll set the value for mail.server as smtp.gmail.com. Next, we have to give a valid Gmail ID for mail.server.username. I will use the admin's mail ID, which is dspace.u1@gmail.com. You can also use the same email ID which you gave as your admin mail ID. The value for mail.server.password has to be the password of dspace.u1@gmail.com. The typed password will be visible to everyone, so I have blurred it for this demonstration. We will now use Gmail's SMTP port SSL:465 to connect to the SMTP server. So let us disable the default SMTP port, which is 25. To do so, type hash in front of the line mail.server.port. Now give a valid email address for mail.from.address. This email ID will be considered as the from address for the recipients. Here I will type the value as dspace.u1@gmail.com. Please type a valid email address for feedback.recipient. If a user submits any feedback in DSpace, then their feedback will be sent to this email ID. Here also I will type the value as dspace.u1@gmail.com. Next, we have to give a valid email address for mail.admin. System notifications and administration emails will be sent to mail.admin address. I will type the value as dspace.u1@gmail.com here. Next, we will configure the SMTP port SSL:465. Scroll down and locate the line #mail.extra-properties. Remove hash symbol at the beginning of mail.extra-properties. Also remove hash symbol at the beginning of the next two consecutive lines as shown. Then save and close the file. Whenever we customize DSpace, it is necessary to rebuild DSpace. Rebuild process involves compilation of source code, installation of web app, and deployment of DSpace on Tomcat server. We will prepare a batch file to rebuild DSpace and use it whenever required. So open WordPad and type the commands as shown. We have used these commands in the earlier tutorial to build DSpace. Save the file by pressing Ctrl plus S keys together. A dialog box to save the file appears. On the left, select Desktop as a location to save the file. Click on the Save as Type drop-down and select the type as Text Documents. In the File Name field, type the name as rebuild-dspace.bat. .bat extension indicates that it is a batch file. Click on the Save button. A dialog box opens to confirm this save. Click on the Yes button. Close rebuild-dspace.bat file. Now let us rebuild DSpace using the rebuild-dspace.bat file. Go to the desktop and locate the file rebuild-dspace. Then right-click on it and select Run as Administrator. If prompted, click on the Yes button in the User Account Control dialog box. The command prompt opens and the process of DSpace rebuild begins. On successful completion, build successful message will appear on the command prompt. After the rebuild process, the command prompt closes automatically. This means we have deployed DSpace email configuration on Tomcat server. Next, we have to configure some settings in the Gmail account which we have used. To access Gmail through DSpace, less secure apps in Gmail settings should be turned on. To do so, log in to the respective Gmail account which you had typed in the email settings of DSpace. Then in the address bar, type the URL as shown. Turn on the toggle button for allow less secure apps. Open a new tab in the browser. Enter the URL as shown to configure Google Accounts access to DSpace. Click the Continue button. Close the tab for less secure app access and Google account access. We have now done the required configurations. Next, let us send a test mail. To do so, open the command prompt. Using cd command, switch the present working directory to dspace bin. Then type this command to send a test email. Test email will be sent to the email ID which was set in mail.admin in dspace.cfg file. Let us cross verify this. Switch to the browser where our mail account is logged in. Now check the inbox for the new mail. Here is the DSpace test mail. We have successfully configured the mail configuration and also sent a test mail in these ways. Once done, sign out from the Gmail account and close the command prompt. If you didn't receive the email, then check the following. Check the spam folder, recheck your internet connection, or the email configurations in dspace.cfg. This brings us to the end of this tutorial. Let us summarize. In this tutorial, we learned to configure email for dspace, prepare a batch file to rebuild dspace, and send a test email from dspace. The video at the following link summarizes the spoken tutorial project. Please download and watch it. The Spoken Tutorial Project team conducts workshops and gives certificates. For more details, please write to us. Please post your timed queries in this forum. Spoken Tutorial Project is funded by Ministry of Education, Government of India. DSpace Spoken Tutorial Series is funded by the National Virtual Library of India, Ministry of Culture, Government of India. This script and the video for this tutorial was contributed by Pankaj Patil from IIT Bombay. And this is Nancy Verkey signing off. Thanks for joining.